What's happening, everybody? Trey here, joined by my dad, Sean, and today at Reactions to the Classics, got another song battle coming your way. This time, as you can see at the bottom, we're having Billy Joel's track, The River of Dreams, versus Mike Posner's I Took a Pill in Ibiza, the Seb remix.
Yep.
Cheers to Attire, a longtime friend and patron of the channel, for putting this song battle together. They put together a lot of unique battles in
yes,
the recent
great
months,
stuff, man.
With kind of some more throwback, classic,
yep.
you know, type artisan songs with something that's a little bit more newer and just you know, like kind of take something maybe from the older track. So looking forward to this.
Yeah, exactly. And if you'd like to support us anyway, as Attire does, check out the Patreon link below or the patron link on the end screen. The patrons make this thing go. Now Trey, you're not going to remember when Billy Joel, The River of Dreams came out because you weren't quite born yet, but off the album River of Dreams in 1993, lead single, 3 in the US and UK. That surprised me. I didn't remember it being that big of a hit, making it his best charting single of the decade, as well as his final top 10 in either country. Hit the top spot in Australia, New Zealand, and on the Canadian and US Adult Contemporary chart.
It was also nominated for the Grammy for Record of the Year, but lost out to Whitney's I Will Always Love You. Billy performed the song at the ceremony and abruptly stopped in the middle of his performance in order to verbally protest Frank Sinatra's lifetime achievement speech being cut off earlier in the night. They cut off Frank.
I know, I like to see wow. I like to see this performance where he just stops.
The production includes a gospel choir and the lyrics deal with inner peace and the afterlife. So as always, man, gonna have the lyrics pulled up, take back, enjoy the song, give our thoughts, and then see what Mike Posner has on deck. A unique cover, to say the least, too.
Very unique cover, dude.
Is this Billy on the cover?
Yes. Very world music-y.
Yeah. Billy was listening to a lot of Paul Simon, Peter Gabriel.
I was going to say, that's exactly right. In the middle of the night, I go walking in my sleep. From the mountains of fame to the river so deep, I must be looking for something, something sacred I lost. But the river is wide, and it's too hard to cross. Even though I know the river is wide, I walk down every evening and stand on the shore. I try to cross to the opposite side so I can finally find what I've been looking for. In the middle of the night, sleep, through the valley of fear, to a river so deep, I've been searching for something, taken out of my soul, something I can never lose, something somebody stole. I don't know why I've been walking at night, but now I'm tired and I don't want to walk anymore. Hope it doesn't take the rest of my life until I find what it is I've been looking for. In the middle of the night, I go walking in my sleep, through the jungle of doubt, to the river so deep. I know I'm searching for something, something so undefined, that it can only be seen by the eyes of the blind. In the middle of the night. If we had the piano pop up from the piano man himself. Yeah.
Not sure about life after this. God knows I've never been a spiritual man. Baptized by fire, I wade into the river that is running through the promised land. In the middle of the night, in my sleep, through the desert of the truth, to the river so deep, we all end in the ocean, we all start in the streams, we're all carried along by the river of dreams, in the middle of the night.
In the middle of the Classic fade out, baby. That was the 80s and 90s.
All right, the River of Dreams bringing it in here, man. They started with the chorus. They hammered that chorus about five times
they
throughout
did.
This track with the you know, backing vocalist, very, as you mentioned, Deb, world music-like.
Yes.
Rhythms were quite prominent as well.
Yeah, but I think it was interesting to me listening to it. I haven't heard it in years. Never really listened to it through headphones or whatever. In the verses, he had a much more throwback sound.
Yeah,
to him.
He did.
It sounded like he did in the late 70s. You know, he's really going in on it. And that world music backing kind of faded away. And then they brought it back in. So, yeah, it was kind of an ebb and flow song.
The piano kind of popped more prominent in those verses as well.
Like, if you pulled out the chorus and just played all the verses, you'd be like, this song could be from 1979 in a good way because he sounds really good. Billy's one of the few guys that I can think of that were mega superstars that got out of it when they should.
Mm-hmm.
He continued to tour, but he got out of it. It's one of his last offerings. So
no, and you know, like, kind of getting a little philosophical,
yeah,
you know, spiritual type of track as well. A lot of, you know, metaphors about the river, and you know, obviously the River of Dreams right here. And what was it? He knows he's not sure about a life after this. God knows I've never been a spiritual man, baptized by the fire, wade into the river that runs to the promised land. Obviously, a lot of biblical type of allusions.
Not sure what's going to happen to him, but he's just throwing it out there wondering.
So, yeah, man, I thought it was, I've never heard a Billy Joel song in this type of
vein,
right?
Yeah, I figured you'd be surprised, So, and I haven't heard it in 30 years or so.
I wasn't sure what I think, but I dug it, man. I dug it. I thought the backing vocalist added a nice touch to it as well. And now we're gonna go to Mike Posner, I Took a Pill in Ibiza, the Seb remix right here, which has an interesting story. It's also known as In Ibiza, or I Took a Plane to Ibiza.
Yeah, because, you know, we can't say I took a pill. Oh, my goodness, man.
Mike Posner is an American. The song originally was an acoustic guitar bass. It was remixed by Norwegian production duo, now they're a trio, Seb, and released as a single in the U.S. in April 2015. Title references Ibiza, a Mediterranean island. I only am familiar with them because New Order recorded a record or was inspired whenever they went to Ibiza, and then they got a little more kind of dance-centric. So maybe it's something about Ibiza.
Which is in Spain.
Yeah, so the pill here, the mystery drug, Posner said, was MDMA.
The Seb remix peaked within the top 10 of the chart in 27 countries. Ooh. Went to number one in Belgium, Israel, Netherlands, Ireland, Norway, and the U.K., It also, in the U.S., it reached number one on both the Billboard Dance and the Billboard Pop Songs chart, peaking number four on the Hot 100, and was nominated for a Grammy Award. Posner talked about the inspiration for the song. He said it was sort of a mystery pill. I was already under the influence of alcohol at the time. I'd written a song with Avicii, I think. I don't know how you say it.
Avicii.
That week in Sweden called Stay With You, and he was playing in Ibiza. So I said, I'll just go there with you because I was already in Europe. It's not like I have a regular 9-to-5 job. So might as well go to Ibiza, right? I had never been there before, so I went. We were all at the show, and I was drinking at the time. I sort of moseyed out into the audience to watch him spin from their point of view. I would go back and forth between the backstage and the VIP area, and then where the actual kids were. And most people didn't know who the heck I was in Ibiza, except for this one guy who recognized me. He was like, are you Mike Posner? Who? I've never heard of. So, and he was all excited. He holds up this little bag of pills. And it's like, you want one? And drunk Mike Posner was like, F it, yeah. So I took one, and I'd never done that before. I don't recommend that, boys and girls. And then I felt amazing. Then when I came down, I felt like 10 years older. So, yeah.
What a story that is.
What a story,
right,
dude.
There.
It's like a true story.
When in Ibiza, I guess. Regarding the remix, Seb said, we got it from Matt Arduini. I probably butchered that.
Yeah, I think he got that.
The VP A&R at Island Records. It was really slow, and we only listened to the vocals on it. Matt sent us the multi-track of Mike's new EP, and we picked Ibiza right away. Such a brilliant lyric and melody, but it needed a new soundscape to be a hit.
So Matt ought to be really lauded, because if he wouldn't have sent this to him, they wouldn't have remixed it. No one would probably know who Mike Posner
is. That's right.
So, wow. All right. I feel like I should know this song, Trey. It sounds familiar, but I don't, like, off the top of my head, know it.
Took a pill in Ibiza to show Avicii I was cool. And when I finally got
I know
sober,
this part.
Felt 10 years older, but fuck it, it was something to do. I'm living out in L.A. I drive a sports car just to prove I'm a real big baller, cause I made $1 million and I spend it on girls and shoes. But you don't wanna be high like me, never really know why like me. You don't ever wanna step off that roller coaster and be all alone. And you don't wanna ride the bus like this, never know who to trust like this. You don't wanna be stuck up on that stage singing, stuck up on that stage singing. Oh, I know a sad soul. Sad souls, darling, all I know are sad souls, sad souls.
I knew the draft was coming. I didn't know when.
Yep.
Cause my name's a reminder of a pop song people forgot. And I can't keep a girl, no. Cause as soon as the sun comes up, I cut them all loose and work's my excuse. But the truth is I can't open up. And you don't wanna be high like me, never really know why like me. You don't ever wanna step off that roller coaster and be all alone. And you don't wanna ride the bus like this, never know who to trust like this. You don't wanna be stuck up on that stage singing, stuck up on that stage singing. Oh, I know sad souls, sad souls, darling. Oh, I know sad souls, sad souls.
I took a pill in Ibiza, the Seb remix. So you said you kind of recognized the opening a little bit.
I recognized just the very opening, yeah. You know, the little bit of the beat in there. Did you recognize it?
Dude, I honestly did. I mean, I've listened to around 1,700 albums in my lifetime, but I do fall short on these really popular radio type songs.
I do too.
Man,
I might have heard it with your sister at one point. I don't know.
But it is interesting. I'd really like to hear the original, because
so would I.
Like the lyrics are very introspective here from Mike, you know, talking about just his fame and kind of the ups and downs. And I mean, all I know are sad songs, and you know, just dealing with that. And you can kind of see how that would fit that slower acoustic.
No, you can, because you know, you don't want to be high like me, never knowing why like me. You ever want to step off that roller coaster and be all alone? You don't want to ride the bus like this, never knowing who to trust like this. So. Yeah, you know, all I know is sad mm-hmm. songs. They really work that. I think it's so interesting what Seb did with this.
Yeah.
You know, even knowing that it was once an acoustic and now it sounds like something totally mm-hmm. different. And so catchy and so tight.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
3 minutes and 17 seconds. You can see how this thing just became a worldwide radio phenomenon.
Oh, yeah.
Because it fits just right. I mean, it is catchy.
Oh, yeah. And my favorite part was when the beat dropped.
Even
though there are some good lyrics in there. Like, you can feel that build up. And you can't help but, you know, just want to bob your head. It just has that catchy nature to it, man. So that's cool how, you know, and that is, I don't listen to a lot of electronic type music, Yeah. But I mean, being able to take something that is so different and then change it into a worldwide hit is, you know, takes a lot of talent, man.
A lot of talent, man.
That's going to take us, though, Dad, to our winner here today. Billy Joel against Mike Posner and Seb. Battle for the ages right here. Tyre set us up against. You want me to go first? Or you want to go first?
I want you to go. I know who I'm picking, but I want you to go first.
Okay. I took a pill in Ibiza. That's what I'm going with, man. No disrespect to the great Billy Joel. You know here that I enjoy me some Billy Joel, the piano man. But that catchy nature to the Posner and Seb track, just it was too much to overcome.
Yeah, and you would think me sitting here being the old guy, I love Mr. William Joel. He kind of starts losing me in the mid '80s, but. I knew that song a lot, but I got to go with I Took a Pill in Ibiza. Dude, that song's fantastic.
It's great. It's still in my head, an earworm for sure, man.
Yeah, but I definitely want to go listen to the acoustic too. So, yeah, great pick by Attire.
And be sure to show Attire some love in the comments below for suggesting this. Let us know your winner as well in the comments. And if you liked what you saw today, be sure to give that thumbs up and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. We upload videos here every single day at RTTC. And you can also check out our Patreon page if you want to support the channel and get a song battle or reaction yourself. But Dad, I guess that'll do it.
That's it
from us today. So until next time, thanks for watching, happy listening, and we will see you.